sick of going to weddings, and I really don't want to go to any more human weddings. And I get the invitation in the mail, Jim and Cindy, destination wedding, Labor Day weekend. You're like, oh my God, that's expensive. I had plans that weekend, Jim and Cindy. You're so selfish. Go to town hall, get over yourselves. You know, you don't want to go. But if I started getting invites that were like, Cindy and Mr. Mittens, destination wedding, like, oh yeah, oh my God. Oh, finally. You know my friend Cindy, you never met anyone? Remember when they let gay people get married and then everyone started marrying pets and shit? Cindy's gonna marry her tuxedo cat, Mr. Mittens. Oh, honey, I don't know if he's gonna wear a real tuxedo over his fur one, but I can't wait to find out. And guess what? Mr. Mittens does wear a tuxedo over his fur tuxedo. Because you went to that wedding. You go to the wedding. It's a beach wedding. And it's wonderful. And Cindy's so beautiful. She's so happy. And Mr. Mittens is terrified. He doesn't like water. He's never seen a tide before. He's taking it personally. He's on a beach. He thinks it's his litter box. He pees everywhere. Cindy still doesn't care. She loves him and he loves her. She's the only woman who ever fed him. He loves her. And you have to sit through human vows. I love you, I love you. And then someone's mom can't find her glasses and has to read a dumb poem by Shel Silverstein. None of that. Maya Angelou did not write those words for you two drips to have at your wedding. She would unwrite everything if she knew what the fuck was going on with her poetry. But the cat people weddings are great. Because there's no vows, because Mr. Mittens doesn't speak English. He doesn't speak. He just stands there being a cat, and you're like, that's so cute. And then Cindy's there, and then they throw catnip at everyone as the party favor, and everyone gets high. And you go, I didn't know humans could get high off catnip. Well, you never fucking let people marry cats before. That's why I didn't know. And love is love is love is love is love, right? Mr. Mittens and Cindy is no different than human love. In 10 years, she will be in bed with something fatter and hairier than when she first met him, right? And unlike people who are dumb and marry other people, and you have to wipe each other's ass at 80 and look at them and be like, oh, you're old and awful. Mr. Mittens dies at 10. Cindy doesn't deal with any of that shit. And she gets to decide when he dies.